Hello students, welcome to the 20th online lecture for the subject of sociology. We will continue with the 6th chapter of our textbook, that is Social Problems in India. Students, please note that 6.3 unemployment and 6.4 farmer suicide has been deleted from the syllabus for the academic year 2021. The topic that we will study in today's lecture is domestic violence, its definition, meaning, causes, consequences, and measures. Domestic violence refers to abuse within the family. Violence implies psychological, emotional, verbal, and physical torture. There are at least two types of persons involved in cases of domestic violence: the one who executes the violence and the victims. Violence within the family goes unreported as it is treated as a personal matter and is perceived to be normal in the patriarchal system. Victims of domestic violence could be anyone within the family or extended family. Domestic violence cuts across all classes, age categories, sexes, and genders. Let us see the definition of domestic violence. According to Merriam-Webster dictionary, domestic violence is inflicting of physical injury by one family household member on another, also a repeated habitual pattern of behavior. Let's move on to study the causes of domestic violence in India. Number 1. Patriarchy. Indian society is largely patriarchal. This means that there is a huge imbalance of power between men and others in our society. The status of women is gradually improving, but the status of transgender persons and children is even lower. In a patriarchal context, there is the unwritten acceptance of male authority. Number 2. Insecurity. Insecurity of one partner, especially of men, can lead to feelings of suspicion, threat to one's ego, one's authority, notions of infidelity, etc. These are reasons enough to cause violence and abuse within the domestic sphere. Number 3. Dysfunctional relationships. There are various factors responsible for strains in a spousal relationship or relationships between different members within the family. This could include personal insecurities, suspicion, age differences, cultural differences, and incompatibility. This can trigger mean remarks, fighting, labeling, verbal spats, and physical assault. Number 4. Traditional and religious outlook. Conventional and traditional mindsets, especially in institutions like marriage, family, religion, demand the supremacy of men over women in almost every sphere of life. Within such a scenario, gender socialization trains the younger generation to conform to the social expectations based on sex, age, experience, authority, etc. Such an outlook has the danger of normalizing violence within the home. Number 5. Heteronormativity. Heteronormativity refers to the social expectation or norm that human behavior must necessarily fit into a gender binary, that is, there are only two ways to identify and behave: female and male. Heteronormativity is a social construct that is often linked to heterosexism, that is, the assumption that heterosexuality is the norm. Non-conformity to heterosexist expectations and stereotypical gender roles is usually discouraged in patriarchal families. The control exerted by adults in the family on the young people during their puberty to adulthood years becomes increasingly rigid. There are numerous instances of gender discrimination, not merely against women, but also transgender persons and gender non-conforming family members. Number 6, vulnerability. Persons who are vulnerable are often the youth, women, disabled persons, the elderly, and dependents. Their vulnerability caused by economic reasons or lack of power and control can lead them to be trapped in the loop of constant exploitation. Instances of child abuse and the abuse of the elderly are not uncommon. Next, we will study the consequences of domestic violence in India. Number 1. Psychological trauma. The psychological and emotional consequences of domestic violence continue long after the violence may have stopped. Victims of domestic violence may need intensive counseling or psychiatric treatment. This means that domestic violence has an adverse effect on mental health. Number 2. Unfulfilled lives. The impact of domestic violence hampers the achievement of one's life goals and aspirations. There may be loss of hope, development of suspicion and negativity, distrust of others. This can lead to individuals leading highly unfulfilled lives. Number 3. Effect on health. Psychosomatic disorder is the term used to describe the physical and physiological consequences of psychological stress or trauma. For example, bedwetting among children, depression among the elderly, irregular menstrual cycle in women, and so on. Number 4. Perpetration of abuse. It is possible that young children exposed to environments filled with violence may believe such behaviors to be the norm. For example, young boys who then believe that it is their right to physically abuse their girlfriend or wife later in life, or girls who think it is necessary for them to be submissive to their husband. Number 5. Decline in individual productivity. A large number of people in their adulthood suffer from poor physical mental health. Physical and emotional state of illness blocks individuals from realizing their full potential and capabilities. This in turn leads to low levels of productivity. Next, we will study measures adopted to tackle the problems of domestic violence in India. There is no quick fix solution to the problem of domestic violence. However, there are certain measures that may be undertaken, such as number 1, creating awareness. As long as domestic violence is perceived to be a problem that must remain within family circles, it will continue to be normalized. It is therefore necessary to create awareness of the fact that domestic violence is not acceptable in a civilized 21st century society. There is a need to alter ways of thinking and to break cultural stereotypes that are detrimental to others by promoting a rational outlook based on equality and social justice for all. Number 2, personal empowerment. It is necessary for all persons and especially those who are the most vulnerable in society to empower themselves through self-help groups, NGOs, age mates, social workers, and so on. Number 3, role of media. Various types of media can help create awareness and sensitize the public about the problem of domestic violence. Media can help to dispel ignorance about domestic violence too. It can present real-life stories of hope, courage, and success. Number 4, role of NGOs. Non-governmental organizations play a significant role in dealing with cases of domestic violence. There are NGOs that specifically work to support women, children, disabled persons, transgender persons, men, children, and the elderly in distress. Often such NGOs are backed with services of legal professional and the police department. Together, they help to get justice for the victims of domestic violence. Number 5, role of law. Laws by themselves cannot transform society, but legal and constitutional provisions make an important and necessary plank for empowering individuals. For example, reading down section 377 of the Indian Penal Code was a significant step in empowering LGBT persons. Gender non-conforming individuals in families are empowered by a law that does not criminalize them. Number 6, role of police. It is very important that law enforcing staff becomes sensitive to matters pertaining to domestic violence. All too often, the police staff may not be sensitive to handling issues of domestic violence. It is treated as a personal matter that must be sorted within the confines of one's home. Such mindsets also needs to change. Today, there are women police staff especially assigned to handle issues regarding violence towards women. Here we come to the end of our lecture. We will study about addiction as a social problem in the next lecture. Thank you.